गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द चैप्टर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम एंड टुडेज टॉपिक विल बी द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड डिफरेंशियल एंड एटॉमिक नंबर एंड मास नंबर. नाउ इन दिस रिप्रेजेंटेशन यू कैन सी दैट हाइड्रोजन, दीज आर द मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल डायग्राम ऑफ showing the different electron and different shells. Okay, so in this diagram, as you can see, this is the nucleus and this is the first shell, that is the K shell. And we know in electronic configuration, the K shell has one electron, so we will draw one electron. Now in helium in K shell there are two electrons, so we will make two electrons. In lithium there are three electrons, so we will make the three electrons in different shells. Okay, that is in K shell we will make two electron and in L shell we will make one electron. Okay, so this is the diagrammatic, the nucleus structure composition and the distribution of electron of elements is being shown in different shells, that is of electron basically. Now beryllium, we know beryllium configuration is 2-2, that is two shell in K, two electron in K shell and two electron in L shell. Okay, similarly if we talk about boron has 2-3 configuration, so 2 and 3 electrons. Carbon 2-4, 2 and outermost 4. Then nitrogen 2-5, so 5 electron in this and 2 in this. First we will fill the inner shell, then we will fill the outer shell. Okay, filling is done like that. Now in oxygen 2 electron in the inner shell and again he is saying 6 electron in the outer shell. Okay, now if we talk for fluorine has configuration 2-7, so 2 electron in the inner shell and 7 electron in the outer shell. Neon has configuration 2-8, so 2 in this shell and 8 in the outer shell. Now talking about sodium has configuration 2-8-1, so 2 in this shell, 8 in this shell and 1 electron in the, that is the M shell. Okay, first shell is K, then L shell and then M shell. Talking about magnesium, that is 2-8-2. So again, we can see the configuration. Aluminium 2-8-3, silicon 2-8-4, phosphorus 2-8-5, sulfur 2-8-6, chlorine 2-8-7, and argon 2-8-8. So in this way, the electrons are filled in different shells, that is the K, L, M, and N shells. And these are the diagrammatic, the nuclear structure and the distribution of electron of the element. Okay, now going on further, talking about valency. So valency is the combining capacity of an atom of an element. The electron present in outermost shell of an atom are called valence electron. That I have told you earlier. The combining capacity of the element to complete its octet in outermost shell, that is the valency. For that, what it do? Either it loses the electron, either it gains the electron, or either it shares the electron. Now valence electron means outermost shell mein jo electron present honge, those are known as valence electron. Now if an atom outermost shell is completely filled, they are inert or less reactive and their combining capacity or valency is zero. It means agar outermost completely filled hai shell, then they will neither lose the electron neither the gain electron. Why? Because the electrons are complete. So in that case the valency will be zero because the element is not either losing the electron and nor gaining the electron. Now coming further, of the inert element, helium atom has 2 electron in outermost shell and the atoms of other element have 8 electron in outermost shell. Atoms having 8 electron in their outermost shell is having octet configuration and are stable. So, do ke liye hum use karte hain, when 2 electrons are present in the shell, then we say duplet, and if we have 8 electron, then it is known as octet or octet configuration. If an atom outermost shell is not completely filled, it is not stable. It will try to attain stability. How it will attain stability? By losing the electron or gaining the electron or sharing the electrons with other atom to attain octet configuration. Now, the number of electron loss, gain or shared by an atom to attain octet configuration is the combining capacity or valency of the element. So, many times I have told you what is the valency, and that is the definition also. Now, hydrogen, lithium, sodium atoms can easily lose one electron and become stable. So, their valency is 1. If we talk about magnesium, magnesium can easily lose 2 electrons, so its valency is 2. Aluminium can easily lose 3 electrons, so its valency is 3. And carbon shares 4 electrons, so its valency is 4. So, carbon neither loses the 4 electron nor it gains the 4 electron. So, what it do? It shares the electron. So, that is why the valency of carbon is 4. Talking about fluorine, fluorine can easily gain 1 electron and become stable. So, its valency is 1. Okay, so fluorine has 7 electron in outermost shell, and to complete its octet, what it requires 1 electron. So that is why fluorine has a valency of 1. And oxygen can easily gain 2 electrons, so its valency is 2. Configuration of oxygen is 2-6. How many electrons required in outermost shell? 6 are there, so 2 more are required. So either it lose the 6 electron or either it gain the 2 electrons. So which one is easy? That is gaining the 2 electrons. So, valency will be 2. Nitrogen can easily gain 3 electrons. So, its valency is 3. We know nitrogen configuration is 2-5. And 5 means to complete it 8, it requires 3 electrons. So, which one is easy? Losing 5 electrons or gaining 3 electrons? That is gaining 3 electrons. So, valency will be 3. Okay? Now, our next topic is atomic number. Atomic number is represented by Z. The atomic number of element is the number of protons present in the nucleus of atom of the element. So, what is atomic number? The number of protons. Okay? All the atom of an element have same atomic number. Like hydrogen atomic number is 1, so number of proton are also 1, helium atomic number 2, lithium atomic number 3. And talking about the mass number of an element is sum of the number of protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons together are known as nucleons present in the nucleus of an atom of the element. See, sometimes we say mass number, sometimes we say atomic mass. So what is the basic difference between atomic atomic mass and mass number? देखिए, जो mass number होता है, the mass number of an element is nearly equal to atomic mass or atomic weight of the element. The main difference between the two is that mass number is always whole number because it is the sum of protons and neutrons which are also present in whole number. Whereas atomic mass is usually not a whole number because it is a relative mass as compared with the mass of C12 atom taken as 12. However, for most of the purpose, atomic mass is taken as equal to mass number. Okay? Now, the mass of an atom is mainly the mass of protons and neutrons in the nucleus of atom. Carbon, talking about carbon, carbon has mass number 12. How? It has 6 proton and 6 neutron. When we will add proton and neutron, the mass number will be 12 U. U is the unit, that is the unified mass, which was replaced from AMU, that is atomic mass unit, to U. U, that is the unified mass. Unified mass means sabhi ke masses ko add karke jo mass aata hai, that is known as unified mass. Aluminium. Aluminium has mass number 27. So in this case, the number of proton are 13 and neutron are 14. So, mass is 27U. Sulfur. Sulfur has mass number 32. So, if we add 16 plus 16, that is 16 proton and 16 neutron. So, mass will be 32U. Now, in the notation of an atom, the atomic number and mass number are written as, first of all, in the center, the symbol is written of the element. Atomic number is written on the left lower side and mass number is written on the left upper side. Like, for example, nitrogen is represented. Nitrogen has atomic number 7 and mass number 14. So, this is the way to represent the together atomic number and mass number of an element. Okay?